think I'm not permitted to exclude evidence on the basis that it's not worth anything. I'm supposed to hear all relevant evidence, and so that's how I regard it. And I'll have to pass on the competence of this, or the weight of this evidence on another occasion, if you follow that.
Yeah, I do, and I'm fine with it. We would be done with this by now if I hadn't opened my mouth, so.
All right, Judge.
So now you have to ask your question.
Remember the question.
You started to say you heard Sean Ryan testify during your...
Was Sean Ryan asked about having a relationship with Sean Furlow? By whom?
My attorney. I'm sorry.
Who was your attorney? Just what he said. Mike Quinn.
Well, I think it was his associate, and I can't remember his name.
And what did Sean Ryan say?
No. She said no.
And
no what?
That she had never been in a relationship with Sean Furlow.
Did she make any efforts to define relationship?
No.
Did your lawyer attempt to expand, or did he just ask, were you in a relationship?
He asked twice, and I don't remember exactly the wording the second time, but he asked twice, very quickly. It was no, another no, I'm done.
Okay, thank you.
No questions, but it turns out I do have just a couple. You talked about a conversation you had with Judge Reeder and a conversation you had with Jody Latuzic, in which, if I understand you here today, you ran past them the concept of your staff doing personal things during work hours.
Personal things for me? No.
Well, I'm going to break it down. I'm trying to understand first what you just testified to a few minutes ago. Did you claim with Jody Latuzic and a conversation with Judge Reeder in which you explained to them, hey, me and the staff, we got nothing to do. Is it okay if we do personal things? And they said, yes, it's okay.
We talked about the fact I did not have enough work to do.
That you did not have enough work to do.
Yes.
Okay.
And I explained some of the things that my staff and I do. They knew that we would leave and that we would go shopping. They knew that, I don't know if Jody knew all of it, I know Judge Reeder did, that there was shopping going on. And that's why he joked, well, why aren't you managing, why aren't you just doing your stocks?
So I want to break this down just a little bit. They never said to you, it's okay to have your staff do personal things for you. Is that correct?
No, I didn't.
You didn't ask that, they didn't say that?
No.
Okay. And whatever they know about whatever you were doing, is that correct?
When I said personal things, I was talking about would have personal things she could do.
When you were talking with Jody Latuzic and Judge Reeder, were you telling them about personal things Christy was doing, or were you telling them you had things that, in fact, did this come up because Judge Reeder saw on the court monitor that you were shopping online and he wanted to talk to you about that?
I didn't know that.
Okay. Then I'll go back to my earlier question. When you spoke with Judge Reeder and with Jody Latuzic, were you talking to them about things you might do with whatever free time you have?
What I would do and what we would all do.
Well, are you telling me that if I were to ask Jody Latuzic or I were to ask Judge Reeder, if they told you it is, Judge Brennan told us the staff is off doing all kinds of personal things during work hours and it's okay. Are you going to tell me that either of them said that?
No, that was not what I was trying to relay. Okay.
Let's try again. What were you trying to relay?
That we had time to do parties for staff, that we had time to decorate Christmas trees, that we had time to go, shopping, that I don't remember exactly everything I would have said, but they knew that they knew we all had free time.
Okay, that's the extent of what they knew, is that you told them that you all had free time. Based on your understanding of your conversation with them.
I would hope they did.
Okay, so if I took anything beyond that from what you testified to here today, that would be my mistake. Is that correct?
I'm not sure what you, when you say personal things.
Well, here's what I thought I heard you say, is that you talked to Jody Latuca and you talked to Judge Reeder, and they both said it is okay for you and the staff to be doing personal things.
I don't know that they ever said it is okay for you and your staff to do all of the things that we did. It was general. It was, got too much free time.
Did they tell you it was okay for you and your staff to do personal things?
They knew we were.
During court hours?
Yes.
Did they?
They knew we were.
No.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I thought you said earlier that you ran it by both of them and they said it was all right for you to do and your staff to do personal things during court hours because you didn't have enough time to do. Did you say that earlier?
Yes.
You did
yes.
say that earlier.
Yes.
Well, you just denied saying that.
I thought he meant personal things for me.
Yes, personal things for you.
No, that's not what I meant to say.
You didn't say that earlier?
No.
Okay, all right. I just wanted to get that straight.
All of us had time to do personal things. Christy had time to shop. Jessica had time to shop. We had time.
I do understand your testimony on that point, so thank you, but I don't need that. I want to know about your conversations with Jody Latuzic and Judge Reeder. And the extent of it, as I understand it now, is you believe that they knew that people had time to do personal things, but never said this is okay.
They knew we had personal time to do things for ourselves. And they, I don't know that they used the word okay, they acquiesced. They did not object. They did not put a stop to it. They did not reprimand anyone. Yes, that's what I mean.
Okay. I don't have any further questions, Your Honor.
Excuse me if I go back to this. The party that Sherry Pollack did for you was when you were first elected to the bench.
No.
She didn't throw a party for you?
No.
I don't remember that either, Your Honor.
I don't remember it either. Sorry.
Did she have any party in your honor?
No.
Well, then I must be mistaken in my recollection.
The parties I recall would be the wedding that Ms. Bullish had at Judge Brennan's home.
Okay. Then, let's make sure.
Sherry doesn't put on parties.
Okay, what? Did anyone have a party in your honor when you got elected to the bench?
No, I put one on.
Okay, thank you. I'm glad I asked.
Nothing further for us.
Nothing further.